don't.
Bloody fantastic.
We would have climbed on your churches and temples, so don't climb on our rock.
I'm an Australian. I was born here. My great-grandparents were born here. And this is part of my culture as well.
Respect the rock.
You look like you need a holiday. A fair dinkum holiday. In the land of wonder. The land down under.
It's 550 million years old. It's been part of Aboriginal culture now for 33,000 years. But in less than 3 months, climbing Uluru will be history.
World heritage, man, you know. You can't walk all over that.
I've always wanted to do it, and I'm just so excited I did it. I'm Australian, and I just think it's part of being Australian.
When you think about it, it's culture versus conquest, isn't it? With a decent dose of controversy thrown in. To climb or not to climb?
In my opinion, no.
Should you climb the rock?
No.
Should you climb the rock?
No.
Should you climb the rock?
No.
As an Australian, as someone who loves their country, this is just like the Sydney Harbour Bridge.
Really?
Absolutely.
Why is it like the Sydney Harbour
Bridge?
Because
it's part of our culture.
It's nothing like the Sydney Harbour Bridge. Who is she? She's a bloody idiot.
With just 81 days to a permanent ban, it seems the world has come to Uluru. Hotels are booked out, planes are jammed, and campsites crowded. As the clock ticks down to October 26, the debate ramps up.
The traditional Aboriginal owners don't want you to climb it.
I know. I know.
But you did anyway.
But I did, but I'm seventh generation Australian, so I always wanted to do it. And there's something that happens with everyone on top. Everyone's just so excited when they get up there, so that can't be a bad thing.
Actually, it can be a bad thing, says Natalie Ray, if you're the Anu, the traditional owners of Uluru, and she is.
Even when I take a walk from work, I start walking and listening to all the birds, yeah. Even when I sit down for a little while, I feel sad why they keep climbing, why they're going into the sacred areas.
To the Anu, like Natalie, the rock is sacred, and climbing it, offensive. Some people are saying the rock belongs to all Australians, not just Indigenous people. What would you say to those people?
It is belong to everybody, but why everybody can come and learn from the ground? The story is in the ground, not on top there.
The story's in the ground?
Yeah.
In other words, says Nat, you learn more about the rock and its history by walking around it, not up it.
So you think people should become educated about the rock?
Yeah, educated.
Not just climb it, get down, go home?
Yeah, not to climb up, to have fun, get down and go back home.
It's their church, so I don't want to go up there.
So sacred?
Yeah. I'll be happy to walk around it. Yes, but my husband's up there, so I've got to wait for him to come back.
Yeah. Do you, you know, the traditional owners don't like people climbing it and they're going to ban the climb?
Yeah, that's okay. Yeah.
You cool with that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm.
Yep.
But you still climbed it anyway?
It's the last chance, wasn't it? Had to do it. My dad did it, so I had to do it. Follow him.
Because normally I'm like a summiter who likes to climb on top of things. Yeah, for this I'm making like an exception because the native people here recommend to don't do it.
To climb or not to climb? I have climbed the rock. It was back in 1985 before the official hand back to the traditional owners. What was it like? It was very steep, it was very scary, it was very windy and very dangerous. And literally for a lot of people, the view to die for. 35 people have died here. Every death, every injury haunts the Anu, and the ban can't happen soon enough.
Losing families around, yeah.
Losing families,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. And there's been a lot of that, hasn't there?
And going back with sorry business.
Sorry business.
Yeah.
You've tried to climb the rock, but it didn't work.
Didn't work, no.
What happened?
Health-wise, your body just can't take it.
You sprained your ankle?
Yep.
Do you disagree with the ban?
Personally, yes.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Are you strong about it? Do you feel strongly about it?
Yeah, I do, actually. Yeah, I do.
Why is that?
I just think it's for everyone.
I can't see the cultural sensitivity when people have been climbing the rock all these years and now all of a sudden they want to shut it down. No, I just don't. I don't get it.
From really sacred to cultural to political, Pauline Hanson says the climbing ban is absurd.
It's no different to coming out and saying, we're going to close down Bondi Beach because there are some people there that have drowned. How ridiculous is that?
Pauline Hanson's got rocks in her head.
I've just got to disagree with you. I don't think it's like the Sydney Harbour Bridge.
OK. Well, you're taking me the wrong way.
Oh, well, I'm not trying to, but I mean, I just think that, you know...
It's a landmark that we're proud of.
Mm,
whether
absolutely.
It's a built one yeah. or a natural one, it's part of our culture, all of us living in harmony. Aboriginal and white Australians.
It's 1964 and the revered rock at 348 metres, the second biggest monolith in the world, is about to be tamed. A local businessman and his team drill steel posts into the ancient sandstone, against the wishes of traditional owners, then attach chains. After half a billion years, Ayers Rock becomes our own Everest. Hundreds of thousands of tourists, local and international, have conquered the climb, with many leaving their mark.
They go do a big squat up on the rock. And you know that squat, that poo, stays up there. And every time it rains, all that poo comes washing down the rock.
Then the visual pollution. This French tourist strips off on top of the rock. Sam Newman poses with his golf club. A kung fu fight scene for a movie. And while we were filming, more contempt for Uluru. Kim and her friends watched a man urinate, then...
There was this lady that's doing a lingerie shoot. That's totally disrespectful, you know.
Look, there is quite a bit of rubbish that's dropped on Uluru each year.
Mike Rousseau from Parks Australia, which co-runs Uluru with traditional owners. He says the ban has been planned for years.
Uluru is probably equivalent to, say, a church would be in Europe, or a temple in Japan, so it's a sacred site. So that's the primary reason why.
It's not easy filming a story on Uluru. Many areas can't be filmed at all for cultural reasons. We've been asked not to broadcast images of people climbing the rock after the handback in 1985, when Ayers Rock became Uluru. We've agreed. Tourists, though, are free to film the climb, take photos, post them on social media, and share them with the world.
There's so many beautiful things to see around the rock, the shapes and the curves and the artwork.
And the colours.
And the history and the colours. Like, you can see all that kind of stuff from the outside. Mm. You don't have to climb it.
Look down from space and Uluru is imposing and incredible. Look up from the red dusty desert and is just as amazing. Tall as the Eiffel Tower and 9.5 kilometres around, somehow it feels alive. It's powerful and spiritual and special.
You must be very proud to be a traditional owner of this amazing rock.
Yep. I am so proud.
You're proud you did it?
I'm proud and overjoyed.
You won't actually be doing it in 3 months.
No. Sadly, all the kids out there and other people won't get to do it.
Attitudes change, laws change, we change. But I reckon half a billion years, just about, says it all.